Hey, Bunny here. I want to build an endless RPG, and I want to populate it with all those different characters that can run around and have their quests, have the containerized worlds where you can have the different mechanics implemented in a different small areas that will be dense with content. And I want it to be easy for the new people to add on it, to have a lot of community generated and nice context. In order to do this, I'm gonna publish some free stuff. And the first part of that would be the character blueprint to Unreal Engine. To have the characters like this that can run to the different directions, and this is all flat art. We can rotate the camera and still run in a different direction. We can flip to the different character, for example, like a bunny, and we can automatically have the bear follow us. And the AI will also use the circle basically to determine when they're supposed to flip between the forward, for example, and three-quarter animation. Because this is quite tricky to implement, and we can also have the static things where we'll have the live bunny versus disappearing live bunny, and we can flip back and forth. So let's review how we get there. And that. Okay, now we can see the same thing in Unreal Engine, which would allow us to analyze what is going on. But I don't think it would be too useful for you to just see how things are already implemented. So let's go ahead and create a new project. I need more Unreals. Alright, so I already tested that, but let's create a new game. And we will use third person template. Select where you want to do it. And just create the project. We go to the link in the description or go to the GitHub and Google Tales Stories. All you need to do is to download the zip. We're gonna start by opening what we downloaded. We're gonna go to the Unreal project that we just created. We go inside the content directory. Inside we see third person BP, and in a folder that we downloaded we also have the third person BP. All we need to do is drag it here and replace the files and open a Unreal project with replaced files. We do have this new blueprint open now. The bunny is here right away. Let's hit play and see what happens. We can move the sphere, but we cannot move the bunny. But we can hit one and things change. The problem here is that if we hit E or Q, nothing happens. We downloaded third person BP folder. We created the new project in Unreal Engine. We used 3D character template. We put downloaded files and replaced the content of the third person BP folder. We created the level blueprint. Now we need to set up the project settings. Step one is to go to project settings, project maps and modes, game instance class, and set it to main instance. We open up Unreal, we click on the settings, project maps and modes, project maps and modes, and we set up game instance class from game instance to main instance, and that will allow us to use the global variables. Let's try this. Go to project setting, but now we go to the engine input, and in here we have action mappings. We already have the one for the jump, but we do want the one for the sprint, and I prefer shift to sprint. Rotate 90L, and this means rotate 90 degrees to the left and rotate 90 degrees to the right, and this would be the E key. Now let's hit play. Hit one, still can move, and can rotate two. Go to project setting, engine collision, and add traced channels. Settings, project settings, engine, collision, trace channels. Add new channel, ledge trace, ignore, accept, battle trace, overlap. Now we should be ready to go. We hit play, we hit one to control our bunny. Let's see what happens if we come to the wall. It does not work. Fun. The reason why it doesn't work? Because not everything is ledge now. And in order for something to become the ledge that we can climb, we need to mark it as such. And if we want some of the surfaces to be climbable, we stop the play, select the wall, we go down and find collision, collision preset custom, ledge trace, change to the block for this wall. Let's see what happens. Now this wall is climbable. For the bunny, let's see what you need to do to replace the arch with yours. We go here and we find the bunny. Hit edit bunny. Let's compile. And all warnings disappeared because we created those guys. And as you can see, I imported it to the brand new project. So if you see something is missing, this means that you skipped some of the step in the GitHub or something changed in Unreal Engine. So you should supposed to have no warnings, no errors here. And this is quite a bit of a mess of the code and a lot of things are happening here. We're gonna review in a separate video what exactly is out there and what do we do with all that. Today, let's concentrate on how do we replace the art in order to finish the character. And this is really very easy. The main two things that you need to concentrate is this box, AI controls, and this box, player controls. When we press W, A, D, and S. So up, down, left, right is a movement of the character. And all we need to do is go here and replace this flipbook. How do we replace it? Let's go to the bunny, let's say front view, and let's import some picture here. We imported some picture and we want to use that for our character. We right click on a picture, hit on sprite actions, create sprite. And if we have animation, for example, walking cycle, we'll just have many pictures and we will create many sprites and we will select them, for example, like this. And we create a flipbook from many sprites. Right now we create from one, because it's just one frame of animation. We create a flipbook and we will call it just this way, DDLC Monica. Now we have this new flipbook. So the easiest way to just replace everything is to go ahead and delete it. And when you are delete the asset, plug in your newly created flipbook and replace the references. And boom, you have the Monica for the front view. And front view was the same one as a back view in this case. But basically, this is all you need to have your own characters. So when you need a walking cycle, you just create the more art. When you need something like the ladders to be climbable, you make them ledge traceable. And you're good to go. Stay creative. Cheers. Cheers. It was just distracting me. Okay. Stop and overlap. Use pathfinding. Let's remove all that. And let's say accepting radius is like right on top of me. And see if it changes anything. Oh, it does change anything.